Hello and welcome in our 9th lesson. Today we're going to speak about the SOP operators needed for subdivide or change the detailization of geometry. We're going to speak about the DivideSOP, combination of PolyReduce and DivideSOP. Then we continue with refine and resample SOPs. We also going to cover subdivide and fractal SOP. Let's continue to the lesson. So let's make some, for example, grid and make it polygonal. And now I can enable convex polygons and triangulate non-planar. So because now all polygons are not planar, it will triangulate everything. Then it can also smooth polygon, and that way you can produce very interesting patterns. And you can even control that patterns using weight parameter. Very nice. Another option, you can make compute dual, which can produce the geometry somehow similar to Voronoi patterns. Let's copy that network and let me change something. So here I can even introduce another operation called PolyReduce, which is not that advanced like in Houdini, but still very powerful. And here we can reduce using percentage. So, okay, now it starts to delete the border points. For that, we have stiffen border parameter. Now I can decrease the amount of percentage. So we produce very nice random grid with adaptive density. And after that, I can enable the divide. And if I remove convex smooth polygons and just enable compute dual, you will get kind of Voronoi grid. And here you can go and do some nice procedural patterns. Next operator we're going to speak about is refine. Actually, that operator is mostly applicable for the spline geometry. So let's create a grid, make that grid a norps type, reduce amount of components. For example, let's make 3x3. Oh, sorry, in you order 4, you need at least 4 components. And in that case, norps geometry only has border lines, because in order to create one segment of norps spline, you need at least 4 control vertices. And now you can see more detailed how the refine operator works. If I enable display, you can see that between U and V, first and second U and first V and second V, it will refine building in 9 divisions. That is a setting by default. But we can, for example, change first and second U and V, and then build this line inside of that segment. You can even increase amount of segments. You can reduce amount of U and V divisions. So that's kind of way to make the spline geometry more detailed. Let's check next one, which will be the resample. Resample is super extremely usable tool. So let's show different cases of usage. So first let's make a line and we can apply the resample operator and let's visualize that. So by default it has 2 versions of resampling. So it takes the original segment, doesn't matter if it's polygon or spline, if it's just a line or closed polygon, and it can split that segment on basis of length and maximum segment. So for example, we can split that precisely on 10 segments or using length 0.1, which for length of 1 unit will bring the same result. But imagine we have 1.1 or 1.05. In that case, so let's also change the position of line so we can see better. In that case, if we split on length basis, you can see that it starts to jump. In that case, we can also enable maintain last vertex, so then it will make the last segment not proper length, but keep the length of line. Depending on what you want, you can use that option. You can also use the amount of segments, then you can separate line on the amount of segments of same length. Let me make that example with maintain last segment. Let's imagine we have some sphere with the polygon of frequency of 1, and then we apply the resample, and let's enable that here, and we can change the length. And you can see if we change the length, it splits the ends of geometry, so it works not so nice. In that case, we can enable the flag called resample by polygon edge. In that case, it will treat every edge as a separated line and resample it separately. So that is extremely practical. Or we can also use maximum segments to split that to the corresponding amount of segments, and it still keep closed polygons, which is also very practical. We can also use X, Y, and Z segments. That's about the resample. Okay, subdivide is another option of making the geometry more detailed. Let's choose, for example, a simple sphere, make it polygon, remove frequency, and then just apply the subdivide operation. Using that operation, we can visualize original shape and subdivided shape. So basically, we can increase the depth, making that more or less smoother. We can use a crease weight, and with crease we can make it more moving to the original shape. And actually we can even control it per group basis. So let me show you how to use the crease attribute and crease group. We can use the group SOP to generate the group. Let's just select, for example, the primitive number 4, and then we should create a primitive SOP and choose that group. And in attributes we need to add crease attribute, remove expression, and then we can control the crease weight for that primitive. In order to see that, we should disable the override crease weight attribute parameter, and then you can see that one of faces started to make that crease. Let me show you the both examples. Subdivide. So I will make 2 subdivides and make some small crease on one side and control it crease on the second side. Next is very simple operator called fractal. It's similar to noise with some small difference. So let's make the grid shape and add fractal. So if we check the original grid and fractal, we can see that fractal. So let's switch to the front. Let's reduce the scale. That fractal is twice more detailed. So it's similar to noise, but it's also subdivided. So we have a subdivision parameter. And we have scale for fractal, we have smoothness, we have fixed boundary, we have direction, we can use a vertex normals. And for example, we can imagine interesting effects if I will use the sphere, which I will switch to polygon mode. Then I will use noise for the point normals. And then I will apply fractal operation based on the vertex normals. Then you will see how that fractal will change its direction, which can produce quite interesting effect. So that way you can create some stackable noise animations. We don't have to increase division too much because it will be slow, but let's say with 3 divisions, it's still working quite well. Follow us on all social networks. And if you go to the howtotouch.com, you can subscribe to our newsletter. So you will be updated about our free lessons, workshops, and all events we organize. Thank you and see you soon.